love somebody the way I love you. To love somebody the way I love you.
BBC News at 11 o'clock. This is Anthony Birchley. King Charles III has been formally proclaimed as the new monarch in a ceremony at St James's Palace. About 200 members of the Accession Council gathered, including Liz Truss and all surviving former prime ministers. The ceremony, which was broadcast for the first time, began with the clerk of the council, Richard Tilbrook, announcing the death of the late Queen and confirming Charles as king.
The Prince Charles Philip Arthur George is now, by the death of our late sovereign of happy memory, become our only lawful and rightful liege lord, Charles III.
The proclamation was signed by members of the Privy Council, including the Queen Consort Camilla, the Prince of Wales, the Lord President of the Council, Penny Mordaunt, and the Archbishop of Canterbury, Justin Welby. The ceremony was then addressed by the new king.
I am deeply aware of this great inheritance and of the duties and heavy responsibilities of sovereignty, which have now passed to me. In taking up these responsibilities, I shall strive to follow the inspiring example I have been set in upholding constitutional government and to seek the peace, harmony, and prosperity of the peoples of these islands.
King Charles also paid tribute to Queen Elizabeth.
My mother gave an example of lifelong love and of selfless service. My mother's reign was unequaled in its duration, its dedication, and its devotion. Even as we grieve, we give thanks for this most faithful life.
During the ceremony, it was confirmed that the day of the late Queen's funeral will be a bank holiday across the UK, although the date has yet to be announced. Her coffin is due to be transported from Balmoral to the Palace of Holyrood House in Edinburgh tomorrow. The proclamation announcing the new king's reign will be read out from the balcony of St James's Palace, with a wave of further proclamations taking place across the UK until tomorrow. Special sittings are taking place today in both Houses of Parliament to allow MPs and members of the House of Lords to pay their respects to Queen Elizabeth. Some will swear a new oath of allegiance to King Charles. There'll be a minute's silence at sporting fixtures this weekend in honour of Queen Elizabeth. Play in the third test between England and South Africa is resuming at the Oval, and the first matches of the new Rugby Union Premiership will take place. But there'll be no horse racing and no football matches, either in the top flight leagues or at grassroots level. That's the BBC News at 3 minutes past 11. Now let's get the travel news with Orna Merchant.
Anthony, thank you. And in London, the routes are busy around Westminster because of the proclamation ceremony. So routes around Buckingham Palace and St James Palace closures are in there, including Constitution Hill, Horse Guards Road and Birdcage Walk, but also roads around Bank Tube Station. Belfast and the M3 on the southbound side at Junction 1A, that's where it joins York Street and the M2. There's an overturned car, so it's looking very slow there. The road's only partly blocked, so you can get past it. The M8's looking good at the moment. No major problems through Glasgow. Go 15 at Townhead to 18 at Charing Cross. County Durham, the A1M northbound, and between 63 at Chesterley Street and 64 at Washington. There are two lanes closed for an accident. And on the southbound side, there's also one lane closed, 64 to 63 again for the same incident. And the M6 heading south in Lancaster around Junction 33 through to the Broughton interchange at Junction 32. That's where it joins the M55. And because of weekend